Well, hello there, all you amazing nerds. This is going to be potentially a long video because we're going over everything or as much as possible that makes sense in Windows security. Because this whole Windows security that was used to call Windows Defender back in the day is probably what makes the current versions of Windows the most secure versions of Windows. There's a lot of people that think that Windows back in the day was more secure and X, Y, and Z. That's not the case. Windows have never been more secure than it is today. A lot of companies, they want Windows Defender or Windows Security only, and with an Azure account that helps them beef up their Windows security, basically, or the antivirus protection, ransomware protection, that actually rivals this with some of the best paid antiviruses out. Windows security, like a lot of, like Avaya and a lot of other security suites, they only, well not only, but they work the best when you have an internet connection. So the threat detection with Windows security goes down from the 95% to like 60% detection, if not lower, without an internet connection. It's the same with like 90% of all antiviruses. If you don't update your antivirus and security database, you are not secure. Okay, let's get into it here. This is what you're getting presented with. It looks corporate, it looks sleek and whatnot. We also have this little menu over here with the burger menu. What I want you to look a little bit at first is just the good old settings. And in my case, I have a security provider. So if you go in here and manage them, you know, I can open the app if I want to. It actually says here, Microsoft Defender Antivirus is turned off. I can go in here, I can open it. I can actually turn it on. You can see here, your firewall is open. You have web protection. You can also then click on here and go into Microsoft Center or Store when it wants to open, and you can see some of their partnered security partners or what it is. You can of course also find third party for them. So we've seen the home screen, we look at settings, let's go down to virus and threat protection. Because I'm using Avaya, I think that's how I pronounce it anyway, this is how it looks like. If I go in here and click on Microsoft Defender and I click periodic, now that will also scan my system. And if you don't have oh, here you go, this is what you need to look at here. So we have like, it has not scanned yet, so you can do a quick scan. You can go in here and you can do scan options, you can do an offline scan, do that once in a while. It's actually really good. Customized scan, full scan, quick scan, what threats you want to allow. If you want a protection history, it actually something we're going to look at later. I'm going to scan now. Virus and threat protection settings, so real-time protection is turned off, used by another antivirus provider. Cloud delivery protection, if you take this off, I think it goes down to like 60% accuracy. Submit, I recommend that you have all of these turned on. If you're not, like at least if you don't have like a third party guy like I have. Manage and control access folders. This is something we could talk about later on in another video, the same in extensions. But you can basically go in here and say, you know, limit access to folders and protect with ransomware and stuff like that. I tried it at work. It works really, really well. But it means that only my account can access X, Y, and Z folders. Look at it a little bit like a protected folder kind of thing, you know. But yeah, if you're not running a third-party antivirus, run this. And this is what I use, like I said, on my work computer at work. All the computers at work, they use this with the updated benefits of running it via Azure and stuff like that. And again, here, virus and threat protection updates. You need to make sure that you have Windows updates turned on. Account protection, you know, kind of self-explanatory. Security for your accounts and sign-ins. So you can manage sync systems, settings, you can manage Windows Hello and Dynamic Lock. All of these will just take you back to basically your control center. Firewall, a quick little easy way to see, you know, domain network, Windows Defender Firewall, it's on. Incoming connection, block all incoming connections, including those in the list above allowed apps. You know, so if you have like allowed apps, ads, you can just go in here and you can just say no, not at all. Private network, the firewall is on, the same here. And if you go in here, you can allow an app through firewall. It will give you this little amazing tool here where you can change the settings. You have a troubleshooter. We have the notification center where you can go in and manage notification. Also manage providers, as we looked at before. Advanced setting will basically open up the good old Windows firewall from your device manager or what you will call it. And you can go in here and you can go nuts with this one here. Most people are not going to need any of these here. If you don't know what you're doing, don't mess with it. Just make sure all of these are on This is the one that I'm using right now. Apps and browser control tool. Enhance protection from untrusted apps. Smart app control setting. It's turned off. If this is turned on, it's basically like a Microsoft approved list that you're running off. And it runs from learning of what, you know, it has a big database. I'm really simplifying this, by the way. If the app that you're trying to install is not approved by the Microsoft databases and stuff like that, you're kind of fucked. You know, you can read more about it here. You can pause the video to read more about it. I don't recommend doing this if you're a home user. That's why I'm not fiddling so much with the same here with reputation-based protection. I kind of have this turned on. Microsoft Defender Smart can help protect your device by clicking for or checking for unrecognized apps and files from the web. Highly recommended. Smart Screen from Microsoft Edge. If you don't use that, you can kind of turn this off. Phishing protection. You know, yeah. Warn me about password issues. Warn me about unsafe password storage. I probably should have all of these on. I haven't had an issue with it yet, but probably. Warn me about malicious apps and sites. Automatically collect websites or app content when additional analysis is needed to help identify threat issues. So this is a telemetry that is needed for you to be more secure. Potentially unwanted app blocking. Protect your device from low reputation apps that might cause unexpected behavior. I don't have anything in here. All of these, you know, I highly recommend having them on. Microsoft Defender Smart Screen, protect your device by checking web content that Microsoft Store app uses. It's a really good thing, this reputation-based protection. But this is only doable with telemetry, people, okay? There's a lot of people hating telemetry, but then you can't get these nice features here. Isolated web browsing, I don't use that one. Exploit protection. Exploit protection is built into Windows to help protect your device against attacks. Out of the box, your device is always set up with protection settings that works best for most people. Control guard, data extension protection, force randomized for images. You know, I will go out on a limb and say don't really think so much about this. Add programs to customize. If you don't know what this means or what it is, like 99% of you people should just keep this as it is, basically. Because it's like they say, they set it up in the way it works best for most people. But look at all of these things that we already are getting for free, people, for free. Where a lot of these features like reputation-based protection, isolated browsing, exploits protection, that actually cost money in programs like Aria or Bitdefender and stuff like that. If you want phishing protection, it costs money, and you get all of this for free already within Microsoft Security. Device security. You know, you can go into core isolations. Memory integrity. Prevent attackers from inserting malicious code into high security processes. I have never used that, but if you're really concerned about your security, it could be a good idea. I do have the driver protection on. You know, it's kind of a little bit, not really, but think about that you are virtualizing, that sandboxing a little bit here. You can also go data encryption, so if you can enable BitLocker. And if there's hardware or standard hardware security, it's not supported on my device. Health report. If available, you can go in here and you can do a fresh restart, but I deleted my restore point from that point, so I can't do that. But it will tell you here if there is an issue. Family options, screen habits, you know, keep track of your children's tickets alive, could be helpful for parental control and whatnot. And of course, protection history. I don't have anything in here because, like I said, I run a third-party antivirus. If you look at Avira, Kaspersky, Norton, McAfee, all of these third-party antiviruses, to get this full protection that Windows Security is giving you here, you have to subscribe for most of them. And most of them are not even better than Windows Security, as long as you keep Windows updates running. I think it's minimum one times a day Windows Security do a security update from the database. And if you know what you are doing, if you have been on the internet more than, let's say, 5 to 10 years, and you are not like a 18-year-old hormone-driven porn watching, porn seeking, let's download and pirate everything in the world kind of mindset, this is all you need. You know what sites to go to, you know what sites are dangerous, you know what links are phishing links, you know what ads are phishing ads. This is all you need. Windows Security is the unspoken, unsung hero, whatever you will say it, of Windows. A lot of people are wasting too much money on third-party antiviruses because they think Windows default antivirus suck. I hope this made sense. See you all later. Bye-bye.